I'm absolutely devastated for Tina. Have a listen to this. Tina, good morning.
Good morning, Lee.
Oh, my God. The worst of news. What happened? Talk us through it.
My daughter's hen, Stacey, today in Magaluf. And I got my Randox test on Wednesday at 2 o'clock.
You went for a PCR test Wednesday at 2 o'clock. Pager 69 euro, I think, isn't it?
Yeah. And they knew that it was a hen. I told them, will it be back now? Because you know you'll be panicking. So she said it'd be back. And I was checking it during the night and there was nothing came through.
You get it within, if you got the PCR test at 2 o'clock on Wednesday, you would have it no later than midnight Thursday.
Yeah, all the girls got theirs back yesterday. I didn't get mine back. So I was still thinking it would come through. So I contacted Brenda then this morning and I told her. And I still went to the airport, Neil.
Okay, so you went to the airport, was it this morning?
Yeah, I went to the airport with the girls, like the bus collected us. And they were trying to get me a test in the airport, but the next available one was at 10 to 11 and it was too late.
What time is the flight at?
5 past 11.
And all the girls got on the flight?
They did. My daughter was heartbroken. She nearly missed the flight because she came back out of the airport hugging me, kissing me and crying.
Oh my God, that must have been an awful experience for you to go through.
I'm going home now with the Mother of the Bride t-shirt on me.
Have you? Oh God, Tina.
Yeah.
Oh no. And they're all gone off to Magaluf without you?
They're all gone off now, yeah.
You have to get out there. Well, how long are they going for?
They'll be back Monday.
Oh no. Now, do you think they took your email down wrong?
It was on the package and she went over with me and it was the right email, Neil.
Now, have you checked your spam folder?
I did, the junk mail I did. I sent it to Brenda. I screenshot it and sent it to
Because I know
Brenda
of people who got PCR tests and they were like you, never checked their spam, went into the spam and there it was.
No, not there.
Now, Brenda's been ringing, no response, no answer. She's been emailing them this morning, no response, no answer, nothing.
Too. Yeah, I did as well. I was on for 20 minutes, Neil, on the way to the airport, and I just hung up then on hold.
Something went very badly wrong because it's very automated. You know, you get it before midnight the next day.
Yeah. And even the girl that took the test, like she was saying, you must be all excited now. She said the girls were just in before you. And I said, I know. Like there was only a half an hour of a difference with us all. So.
And all of the other girls on the hen went at the same time as you?
Yeah, all around the same time, yeah.
Tina. There's a flight tonight at 10 to 8 out of Dublin.
I couldn't on my own. I couldn't, Neil.
Why?
No, I just couldn't.
Are you a nervous flyer?
I am a bit, yeah.
Oh, no.
I just wanted to be with the girls, like Neil. They were having a great time, you know, going out.
Oh, no. I remember a couple of years back, and it's one of the reasons why I love to fly United Airlines. We were going to New York, and my wife, there was an issue with her ESTA, you know, it's a special pass that you need to get into America. She didn't have it when we queued up and went to the desk and everything, and they were told, no, this is wrong. The three of us got on the flight to New York, and she was left behind. It was off. Now, she got a flight about 2 hours later. United sorted everything. No charge, nothing. Free as they got her on a plane to Washington and another plane. But it was just that feeling at the airport, leaving someone behind.
I know. It was heartbreaking. And my daughter, she's my eldest daughter, and it was just heartbreaking, you know, separating from her in the airport, so...
There's a flight, there's a Ryanair flight in an hour and 10 minutes out of Cork. Could you not get someone to go with you if you could get the PCR now or in the next... Or maybe you could buddy up with someone on the flight who could look after you.
I don't know, Neil.
just say to someone, I'm a nervous flyer, can I chat to you? I don't know. You know, we could get on to Kevin Cullinan at Cork Airport. They might make it work.
I'm on about to test, Neil.
I know, but if we can get the... I can talk to the lads again here and see if... Could somebody drive up there to Silver Springs?
Yeah, I was going to go there now myself. But I still wouldn't make the flight then, Neil, I'd say. I don't know.
Well, I'm just thinking out loud here, 22 minutes past 11. If we could just get the PCR test sorted in the next 10 or 15 minutes, get you to the airport, get on to Kevin Cullinan, head of marketing at Cork Airport, see if we can get you on the plane. Will we try?
Where will I get the test? Will I go down to Silver Springs? Or will I go to the airport again?
I don't know if there even somebody listening who's near Silver Springs right now. I could get Seamus Whelan to get to Randox in Silver Springs within the next 15 minutes. Where are you?
I'm near Mahon Point now.
Okay, let's get Seamus to Randox in Silver Springs. Let's get you to the airport. Let's get on to Kevin Cullinan, which is happening this second as I'm speaking. Emer's on the phone to him. And let's see what we can do in the next hour and 10 minutes, all right?
Okay, will I head back to the airport, Sonny?
Don't, just stay on hold there. I'll put you back to
okay.
Brenda. And then
Thanks very much. And
we'll see if we can get you on that plane. And we'll see if Seamus can get there.
Thanks very much, Neil.
Yeah. Okay, hang in there. We'll see if we... Seamus will get to Randox at Silver Springs and see if we can just get that sorted. It could be just done with the push of a button. I'll come back to this before midday.
Our phone lines remain open after midday. 1850 104 106.
Okay, what time is that flight at? Is it 20 past 12? The Ryanair flight to Magaluf, 20 past 12. Connor Phelan has Phelan's Pharmacy on the Kinsale Road. I know it well. Connor, good morning.
Good morning, Neil. How are you?
You can get an antigen test done. And how quickly can you get the result to her?
Well, the result, we can email it to her. She's on her way up to the airport. We'll have it after 15 minutes for
okay.
her.
Okay, so if she... Because
so
she's
she
on her...
pop into us, get an antigen test and head straight to the airport and we'll email the result.
Do you think it's possible to get her on a flight in less than an hour?
I don't know how the airports and airlines work, unfortunately, but certainly from our side of us, we'll have her in an hour and 10 minutes.
Okay, so let's... I've also got a guy at Silver Springs at the moment just checking with Randox as to what the story is with her test. So I'm going to allow him to proceed with that, and if that happens well and good, she can get the email of the PCR test. But if I send her to you, because she's on her way, she'll be passing your way, will you do test...
We'll do it immediately for her, yes.
Okay,
yes.
And do the test and then she can continue on to the airport and you can then email the result.
The test result to her and the digital travel cert that she needs to travel. So well, she doesn't need the one with the QR code we'll give her that she can use for travel. So we'll email that to her within 15 minutes.
Okay, fantastic. Yes. Okay, fantastic. The clock is on. I wish I had more time, but I can only deal with the time that we have. Okay, Connor, let's get that done either way. If Randox comes through, that's fine too. But let's get her over to you, get that test done and send her to the airport. Let's do that. Okay.
All right. Okay,
thanks so much, Connor, as always. Cheers. Fair play to you. Always at the end of the phone. So she's going to... Is Brenna going to make that happen? Is she going to divert so to Phelan's?
She's on her way back, yes, so she can go to Phelan's or if Randox, if we can get Randox on the line there, I'm just waiting to
she's
get
she's actually on the line there, Nogan, Neil. Just Phelan's let me check
on the line
what
as well. The problem
number.
We have now is Cork Airport and getting the flight booked for her because the flight is at 12:20.
Has anybody checked availability on the 20 past 12 with Ryanair?
I think it's 1 second there now. I know,
but at least she's moving anyway in the right direction.
She's on line 6 there now and she's on...
Look, I'm just going to check in with Randa.
Tina.
Hi, Neil.
Are you mobile? Are you all right?
I am.
You upset?
I am.
But are you actually travelling now, moving in a car?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you know where Phelan's Pharmacy is on the Kinsale Road?
Kinsale Road's roundabout Phelan's, is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's on the... Yeah. You need to get there now. Connor Phelan is waiting for you. He'll give you a test. You leave your email address. Yeah, the mic is open if you wanted to jump in, Brenda. He'll do the test. You go to the airport. We're checking the availability of flights on the Ryanair flight. Just hold on a second.
Well, it's coming up there now, Neil. It's 97.99 euros. It's... You can only purchase it at the airport or calling the call centre. I'll ring the call centre there and explain it to them. I'm just going to tell them to hold the plane, to be honest. I am. I'm going to say, hold that thing there now.
There's a place on the plane.
There's a place on the plane, but you can't book it online. But I'm going to ring them now and I'm going to tell them, hold that plane.
You can't book it online.
You have to ring the call centre or you book it at the airport.
So you will. Can we help?
We're going to try to do that there now.
Okay. All right. So you should be able to buy the ticket. Have you the money for the ticket?
I have my card, Neil. Bank card.
Okay.
And I have money. Yeah, I have money with me as well.
So apparently you will be able to buy, Brenda's on it now, you will be able to buy a Ryanair ticket at the airport, they're telling me.
Okay.
But you're moving all of the time as we speak towards Phelan's and the Kinsale Road, are you?
Yeah, Phelan's towards Kinsale Road.
Yeah. Do you know where it is? It's on the same side of the road as Harvey Norman's.
Same side of the road as Harvey Norman, okay.
Where are you approaching it from? Are you on the link or where are you?
The link, yeah. Okay,
so you obviously come off that, go around the roundabout, take the first exit as if you're going for the Tramore Road.
Okay. Right.
And on your left-hand side, there are businesses and shops. Factory Carpets is there. There's a pet shop there. And next to the pet shop, there's Phelan's Pharmacy.
Okay, Neil, thanks.
So you go in there. He'll stick it up your nose, won't hurt. Go straight to the airport and he'll email the result, okay? You'll have it in 15 minutes.
Okay, thanks very much, Neil.
So no walking now. You need to run on this one, okay?
Okay, thanks.
Okay, don't be upset. We'll do our best to make this happen. And Brenda's on to the airport. And just stay in touch, all right? Even stay on the phone for now. I'll put you back to Brenda, okay?
Okay, thanks.
All right, take care for now. We'll talk again in a few minutes' time, Tina. Okay.
Call the Neil Prendeville Show now. 1850-104-106. Red FM.
Okay, you're going to hear Jennifer Clark and Chris O'Hearn tuning up here, so don't worry about that. But back for the latest update on the saga and Tina and the hen party to Magaluf. Eimear.
Yeah, so Tina is at the airport.
She's there.
She just arrived at the door, yeah. She's about to go up to the Swissport desk. The airport are aware of the story.
Do Swissport want pizza? Four pizzas, two sides?
I don't know, but we're having some trouble on the Randox side of things now, just in terms of, we believe now that it's her email address is the problem. They were sending it to the right address. So we're trying to get it sent to another address, but obviously there's various
hoops
that need to be jumped through. No, I'm just so stressed out. I really want her to get on the flight.
Yeah, we're just really wanting her to go. Yeah.
You don't know the pilot I was asking?
No, I don't know him at all. Surprised I don't.
Any of the cabin crew or?
Well, no, the Swissport are all good. It's just the PCR. It's her email is the problem and her friend that's with her. Like, we're trying to get the email sent there, but there's a few issues and stuff like that. But I'll check with her there now.
Tina, where are you?
We'll be all right. Give us a musical interlude with Jen, will you?
Are you at the Swissport? She's on six there if you want her again.
What am I going to say to her? I have no news for her yet. Tina!
Hello.
At least you're in the airport.
I am.
Yeah. And at least Randox are trying to send the cert to somebody's email.
I just got a text from Swissport saying they'd love pizza.
I'll give them pizza. Tell them no problem. Four pizza for Swissport if we can get him on this flight or get her on this flight. Is there a problem with your email?
I don't know, Neil, because there was emails coming. Oh yeah, I got it.
Oh, Jesus, my heart.
I got my chest.
Okay, she's now got the email of the QR code test. Can you go? Are you at the Swissport desk?
I'm with them here now, Neil. They're around me.
Okay. Pick it up, Brenda. What'll happen next?
They'll book the flight, hopefully, which is now boarding.
They will put
Someone
you on
will
that.
Rush her through security.
They will put you on that flight, right?
Yeah.
I will send them four hot pizzas with sides as a thank you, and you go and enjoy the hen and Magaluf.
And anyone,
thanks very much.
Anyone who knows anyone on the flight, the Ryanair flight, please be nice to Tina and mind her because she doesn't like flying. Whoever's sitting next to her, hold her hand.
Thanks so much.
And have a gin and tonic when you get on the flight.
No, I don't drink, Neil.
Tina, drop us a message when you're on the plane, all right?
I will. Thanks very much.
All right, go on. Go and do that, all right? And I'll talk to you from Magaluf on Monday, all right?
Okay.
All right.
Thanks, Neil. Bye.
Cheers. Anyway, I won't be here after 12, but I'm sure that Phil Burke will come back and update, will he?
Perfect, yeah, yeah.
Listen, well done, the two of you.
Jesus. All in the day's work.
Red FM.
Listen, before I love you and leave you, just let's see if that got completely mopped up and tidied.
Of course it did. Of course it did. Who do you think you're working with? She's currently going through security. So we just have to say a massive, massive thanks to Brian Dunphy. He was our man who went up to Randox. He's helped us with other things in the past as well. He's Mahon Glenthorne man. Well, he was Mahon Glenthorne.
Did he get the Randox thing sorted?
He got the Randox thing sorted for us. He didn't want to go on air or any publicity, but I said I'd have
What's
to
his
mention
name?
Him. Brian Dunphy. He's from Mahon originally, living in Glenthorne.
What was wrong? It was her email.
It was the wrong email. Well, it was the right email rather, but it just wasn't going to her. So we jumped through some GDPR loops and it's sorted.
Well done, Brian Dunphy.
Sorted. Yeah, thank
what,
you.
I mean, they must have wondered what the hell is this guy on about.
I know, exactly. And thank you. I know we've a lot of people up at Cork Airport listening and they're fantastic. So thank you to all of them, especially the lads in Swissport. Who else do we have to thank?
I'm still trying to ring Tina here because I want to top it off, you know, with her on the plane. Go, I'm on the plane. She's not answering.
Oh,
me
yeah.
Now.
There's a text in there from a lady who said her son is on the flight and they're waiting for her. But actually, I've just checked and they're in the departure lounge. They haven't boarded yet.
This is the Neil Prendeville Show. Tweet the show at NeilRedFM. 104 to 106 Red FM.
Okay, in case you thought I was gone, I'm not. I'm back again for another few minutes because we just want to wrap this story. And thanks to Phil Burke for allowing us to stay on the air for another few minutes. I'm joined by Niall McCarthy, the manager of Cork Airport. Niall, good morning.
Good morning, Neil. Good afternoon it is now. How are you?
Listen, thank you so much for everything that everybody did to help Tina. When did you become aware of this commotion?
You know, Neil, I'm not going to take an ounce of credit for this because the person who worked the magic is our general manager operations, and that's Dorothy Coffin. She's right here beside me.
Okay, so I got a call
about 20 minutes ago and I was in a meeting. And as always happens, I delegated the problem or the challenge to Dorothy, and Dorothy took over there. So I'll put her on to you.
Yeah, sure. She can talk me through it then. Thanks, Niall. Thanks so much. Well done. Dorothy, good morning.
Good morning. How are you, Neil?
I'm talking to the General Manager of Operations, so top of the tree. Talk to us. When did you hear about this situation that we needed solving, and how did you go about fixing it?
Okay, a colleague of mine made me aware. They were listening to the radio and they could hear the interview, what was going on with yourself. So we went to try and figure out what was happening and to try and identify the lady. So there was a lot of to-ing and fro-ing between, was she an Aer Lingus passenger? Was she a Ryanair passenger? Because we hadn't heard the full interview. So we kind of pieced it all together and we went looking frantically for her.
Yeah, PCR tests, emails, trying to book tickets, trying to get her to the airport.
So we just, yeah, and we confirmed that an antigen was sufficient because Spain is accepting antigen tests. So in fairness to Randox, they turned it around, I think, in 20 minutes for her.
Wow.
So we rebooked her onto the Ryanair Palma, which was closed, but we got Swissport, in fairness, excellent to facilitate her. So we booked her onto that and fast-tracked her through security, printed off her negative test for her because she was a bit, I suppose, there was so much going on.
She's overwhelmed, yeah.
But, you know, I just told her she'll be fine and she'll be relaxing tonight and she'll be, you know, able to tell the story in years to come.
Yeah, hang on a second there if you don't mind, Dorothy. Tina, good morning.
Morning, Neil.
Where are you now?
Hi, Neil. I'm going on to the plane now with Maria.
Are you walking on?
Maria O'Sullivan, yeah.
How close to the plane are you?
Very close. Where are we, Maria? Will I put her on to Neil?
Just to find out, will I hold on to see if I can get you literally in the doors? Is Maria your escort?
Hi, Neil. I work for Swissport here in Cork Airport. I think I saved the day by making the booking. Got the flight opened up for her in the airport.
Well
I'm
done.
After putting her shoes on, tying them up for her, getting her ready, and I'm taking her to the aircraft right now.
Right. How long will that take, do you think, Maria?
To get her to the aircraft?
Yeah.
I reckon 2 minutes, not even. We're giving her VIP treatment all the way.
Okay, I'd love to
see. If you see the magic, you can work.
See the magic, I'm telling you.
We got Niall, we got Dorothy, we got Tina, we got Maria.
Well, I tell you, we can pull rabbits out of hats, when you get on the air.
You certainly did pull out all of the stops, because I know there are protocols involved, so thank you so much for doing all of that, particularly to Dorothy Coffey and indeed to Maria.
It was a pleasure.
Will I wait until you walk on board?
do, and you can actually wait, and I'll tell you when we're actually going on the aircraft, okay?
Okay, okay. Just go for it there. I'll hang on.
Yeah, yeah, we're going down the list there now, one sec.
That's about 30 seconds, Neil, to race across the tarmac. And it's a great day, so there's no rain today.
Busy morning this morning, Niall and Dorothy. I don't think you expected that when you got out of bed.
Every morning is like this, don't worry.
Yeah. We've had lots of drama the last 18 months, as you know well, Neil, but yeah. It's getting better, it's getting better.
But this is a great news story. And we've managed also, lads, to reverse Friday the 13th.
Yeah. We'll jinx it now, Neil, by bringing that into us.
No. Well, I should have kept my mouth shut until she's actually on the plane.
I have everything here.
Where are you, Maria?
Yeah, we're just coming out of the lift there now, and we're walking through. Yeah, we're just heading out to the aircraft.
So that should be maybe, what, 60 seconds, perhaps, something like that?
Oh, even less. Yeah.
Even less?
Yeah, 20 seconds, 1 minute there now, we're nearly there.
Now, there's the magic we can work in. Thanks to Dorothy, by the way. Dorothy copy, but we don't want every member of the public ringing Dorothy now when they have a problem.
No, this is a very special case. Special case.
Once in a while.
Do you want to go on a hen, Maria?
I'll go, no problem. I'll take over the hen.
It's Stacey's hen. Stacey's going to get some fright, though.
We can make it Maria's hen now when I come with her.
They're across the runway now, are they, Niall?
Yeah, we're just...
Oh, they should be at the aircraft now. Maria, go on. Tell us, where are you?
We're just heading up the steps of the aircraft there now. Just
the there you go, Neil. Job done.
Okay. I'll put you back to Tina there.
Let me see what happens when she goes into the air. All right, where are you?
I just put up the steps of the aircraft.
Stacey is going to get some shock when she sees you.
I know. I mean, when I get to the other side, now I won't know where I'm going. My first time now.
Don't worry. There's people on board that airplane will look after you all of the way, even after you land, all right?
They were very nice, Neil, everyone in the airport.
Oh, that's great.
So nice. And Maria.
We'll be on to Stacey while you're in the air, and when you land, everything will be well. Stacey will be made aware that Mam's on the way.
Neil, you're very good. Thanks very much for making it happen.
Are you inside the cabin yet?
Yeah, in now.
Delighted. Job well done. Okay. Well
thanks
done.
Very all much. Right.
Have a great flight, Tina. Enjoy the hen, all right?
Thanks. Bye.
Thanks, Maria. Thanks, Niall McCarthy. Bye. And a big special thank you to Dorothy Coffey, the General Manager of Operations. Thank you all, guys.
Thanks, Neil. Enjoy your day.
Take care.
Bye.
Cheers. We'll touch base with you, Tina, on Monday to see how the hen is going, or indeed how the weekend went. Job well done. Have a great weekend. Thanks, everybody. Can we pretend that airplanes in the night sky like shooting stars? Neil Prendeville, the voice of Cork. Weekdays 9 to 12. Cork's Red FM.